Hello, I'm Mary, and thank you so much for coming. I pray that as you listen to this video today, your life will not remain the same again.
In every battle in the heavenlies, give him thanks for the blood. In Jesus' name, you know, without the blood, there is no atonement for sin. Without the blood, the dominion of sin continues. Without engaging the blood, the freedom from the horror of sin is impossible. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. Thank you, Jesus, for the blood. It does not only purge our behavior, it purges us from inside. How much more shall the blood of Christ purge our conscience from evil works to serve the living God. Hebrews 9:14. We'll do one more time. Lift up the two hands and thank God for the blood. Thank God for the cleansing and wholeness power of the blood. Thank God. Thank God. Now ask him to speak to you tonight, every one of us. Jesus, speak to me tonight in person. I want to hear from you. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Lord Jesus, we thank you again tonight for the privilege to be in your presence. Thank you for the bright clouds preceding Shiloh. Thank you for your visitations in individual lives. Thank you for getting us ready for the marvels you have in store for us at Shiloh. Take all the praise in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Fortune is my portion in 2024. Congratulations. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. And please, you may be comfortably seated. Thank you, Jesus. Every move of the Spirit is preceded by bright clouds. He said, ask of the Lord rain in time of the little rain. The Lord will first make bright clouds before he causes showers of rain to come. That's why we have pre-Shiloh encounter services. There are bright clouds preceding the showers. Bright clouds preceding the showers. Bright clouds preceding the showers. May no one miss the blessings of the bright clouds as we get set for this great feast of the King. Shiloh is a great feast of the King. It's a great feast. A feast of far things. Of far things full of marrow. Of wines on the lees. Wines on the lees very fine. And he takes off the face of covering that's cast upon all people. Granting us access to the things behind the Holy of Holies. And there, it will wipe off tears, wipe tears away from off all faces. It will swallow up death and victory. Those are the things in his feast, not liver, mixed meat, boiled rice or fried. It's a feast of spiritual fat things that brings an end to our leanness, terminates our shame and reproach, Wipe away tears from off our faces. What will happen then? We start showing by what is happening now. So get ready for it. Praise God. We are on part 5 of this teaching series, putting up a fight against the forces of righteousness. It's not putting up a wish, putting up a fight. It's not keep waiting to overcome the force of unrighteousness, putting up a fight. We saw this again in 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 10. He said, "For the love of money is the root of all evils, with why some converted after they have pierced themselves through with many sorrows." And that drown men to destruction and perdition. But O thou man of God, flee these things, or follow after righteousness and godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness, and fight to see that happen. So you can lay hold on eternal life. There's a fight. It's not a wish, it's not a waiting. It's a fight. Remember, profitable focus is godliness is profitable unto all things. But we exercise ourselves in order to excel if that's our choice. Exercise thyself rather unto godliness. For bodily exercise profits little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having the promise of the life which now is, and the one which is to come. We follow the particular pattern in this series, first to identify the nature of sin so as to learn how to keep away. Tonight we look at the fact that sin is pleasurable, but only for a moment. Hebrews 11, 23 to 25. Moses chose rather to suffer affliction with the people of God rather than to enjoy the pleasure of sin for a season. It's always for a season. It's always for a season. The rat is caught as he rushes at the bait. We don't know it was leading to her, to his death. The bait looks sweet. Oh my God, this is free food. I've been hungry all life. Swallows it. And then he feels good for a while. And then suddenly, what happened? Pleasure of sin is but for a season. In Proverbs chapter 5, verse 3 to 5, "For the lips of a strange woman drop as an honeycomb, and her mouth is smoother than oil. But her end is bitter as one wound, sharp as a two-edged sword. Her feet go down to death, and her steps take hold of hell." Now, what is this like? Bribery looks sweet, but it ends up corrupting destiny. Stolen water looks sweet, but the end is always bitter. It's always for a season. We also try to identify spiritual forces behind sin. Satan is defined as the man of sin. That is, his ministry is called the ministry of iniquity. That's his ministry, is to get you and I trapped by sin or trapped into sin. And he does that by those foul spirits that fell with him when he was cast out of heaven. They are demon spirits. And among them is the spirit of pride. You know, it was pride that brought him down. Isaiah 14, verse 12 to 15, talks about Lucifer. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground with this weakened the nations? For thou hast said in thy heart, so it's domiciled in the heart, I will ascend into heaven, and I will exalt my throne about the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I'll be like the Most High God. Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the size of the pit. So that was the spirit that brought the devil down. And all the ones that joined the coup came down with him. And they are still at work today. We saw the story of Uzziah. He was so marvelously helped. And then his heart was lifted up to his destruction. Heart. The face is still calm and cool, but the heart is lifted up, I mean, by my reputation. See what I've accomplished. I mean, this is not just God, though. It's me and God. It's very subtle. It's his spirit. And the intent of that spirit will grow this end time. Because God has an agenda to keep lifting his people. But not all the lifted will survive it. Because in the last days, perilous times shall come. Men shall be proud and arrogant, incontinent. You can't reach them. So his heart was lifted up to his destruction. And Uzziah was so marvelously helped, his friend went around the entire world, ended up a leper, and lived as many days as a leper, and died as a leper. His heart was lifted up within himself. Pride always goes before destruction, and a haughty heart before a fall. As ordinary as that may appear, some have left some service units because they are not made leaders there. That's where it begins. Everybody should know I should be the secretary of this group by now, with all of my activities. Made them see my activity. And God said, if I put you there, you will fall. So don't stay there. Stay here first. Until you pass the test of meekness, you are not a candidate for greatness. Until you pass the test of meekness, no one is a candidate for greatness. You won't miss your place. Pride is a spirit. It's not an attitude. It's a spirit. It must be fought. It's an unclean spirit. He gave them power against unclean spirits to cast them out. So it's a thing to cast out. It's not a thing to watch. It's a thing to cast out. Matthew 10 and verse 1. And then we have the spirit of bondage, or what we call addiction. The spirit of bondage. In Romans 7, verse 14 to 19, I have a picture here that shows how this spirit operates. For we know that the law is spiritual, but I'm carnal, sold under sin. For that which I do, I allow not. For what I will, that do I not. But what I hate, that I do. Now, come. Most victims of drug addiction are poor people. So how did they get money? Because the thing is costly, I'm told. So they go for robbery operation in the night to smoke the only day and go for robbery in the night until they kill them. Yeah, they don't want to die, that's why they run. If you want to die, won't you stay? You run to escape. It's bondage. Bondage, raw bondage. Raw bondage. Now, go on in that scripture, chapter 7. If then I do that which I will not, I consent unto the law, that's good. Now then, it's no more I that do it. Can you see that spirit? But sin that dwelleth in me. And Satan is the man of sin. So that's what happens. It's a spirit that holds people into bondage to things that they will not normally want to do. I was in one of those dungeons, one of my outreaches, and I saw these folks, you know, smoking marijuana, everything smelling. And I called them, I said, hey, wait a minute, do you want your children to be like this? They said, no. Why are you here? They said, we don't know too. Direct. I said, I know why you are here. You are under an influence beyond you. Jesus came to set you free from it. That we don't know too, but we are just here. When we finish smoking, we go under the bridge again and go and lie down. Bondage. Bondage. In the name of Jesus, every spirit of bondage that's blocking the way of God's people forward in their walk with God, I command them cast out. Amen. Can I hear your amen? Amen. What a good God we serve. Romans 8:15. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage. So there's a spirit of bondage that holds people bound. But you have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. This is not your agenda for my life. Abba, Father, rescue me from this. Abba, Father, let these chains fall off me. There's a spiritual bondage that we must stand up to and overcome. And how do we overcome them? In my name, you cast out devils. Your head are in the pit. By my blood, you come out of the pit. So we engage the name, we engage the blood to break the hold of bondage in our lives. Something great is on the way happening. And it's happening for you. Whatever habit that's not moving you forward is bringing you downward. You are going forward from now. What are some of the benefits of godliness? One, it secures supernatural prosperity. Malachi 3, verse 1 to 4. I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Even the messenger of the covenant, whom ye delight in, behold, he shall come, said the Lord of hosts. But who may abide the day of his coming, and who shall stand when he approaches? For he is like the refiner's fire, and like the fuller's soap. And he shall sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he shall purify the sons of Levi, and purge them so thoroughly as gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. Then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant unto the Lord, as in the days of old, as in former days. So there's a place to stand for our offering to be accepted. There's a place to stand for our offering to be acceptable. And if it is acceptable, it cannot be profitable. Until the earth receives our seed, it cannot be turned into harvest. Jesus said, when you bring your offering in unto the Lord, and then you discover there's an odd between you and your brother, don't drop it or you waste it. Go and make it right. And come and give your offering. That's how, what is missing today, what you call prosperity message. Offerings must first be acceptable before they become profitable. May our offering from now be acceptable unto God. Amen. Can I hear your amen?
Amen.
Psalm 112, verse 1 to 3. Blessed is the man that feareth the Lord, that delights greatly in his commandments. His seed also shall be mighty upon the earth, the generation of the upright shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. Okay. So you see upright, you see righteousness, you see fearing the Lord. They are all part of the package that secures true prosperity. Not make-up prosperity. Not jamboree prosperity. Abraham said, I will not take a thing from you lest you say you make Abraham rich. Chapter 14 of Genesis 21 to 23. 23 in particular. So there's a consciousness of what can make a prosperity heritage, can get a prosperity heritage lost. I will not take anything that is dying. I won't rob you. I won't take from you. Let's just say you make Abraham rich. I will not take anything that is dying. You are working in an office, I will not take anything that is dying. You are in partnership in business, I'm not taking anything that is dying. I'm not going to play you out. that will block my access. In Proverbs 8 and verse 18, hear what he said. He said, riches and honor are with me. That's wisdom. Yea, durable riches and righteousness. Durability demands righteousness. Durability of riches demands righteousness. Demands righteousness. I was 20 when I heard this scripture, Jeremiah 17:11. As the ostrich, he calls it partridge in the King James version, seated on eggs and hatches them not. So it's a man that getteth riches, but not by right. He shall leave it in the midst of his days, and at the end he shall be what? A fool. So many people duped the organization some 2 years ago. They are still in the prison now. Is that life? 2 solid years of a man's life, and there's no end to when they will leave the place. So where is the value of that money now? Shall I leave it in the midst of his days? They left young wives behind. Young children languishing in the prison, causing pain and emotional distortion to those precious people. So I met a friend of mine on the grounds of Landmark University 2016, and he said, sir, you share something with me 1974. Our childhood friends. And then he said, that word has never left me. That to get rich is not by right, you live it in the midst of your days. Now, I didn't know the meaning of ostrich or partridge. So he asked me when I shared with him then, he was still telling me the form. He said, what is ostrich? I said, I don't know, but whatever lays egg must be a bird. That's what I know. I've never seen ostrich. Amen. Whatever lays egg must be a board. Don't stay off whatever is not yours. Stay off it. Stay off it. It's not adding to you, it's poisoning you. Stay off it. Stay off it. Someone came in from Kaduna here to buy some goods in Lagos years ago. And then he discovered that they gave him excess change. They were the days of cash. He returned to give them the change back. They said, what? Are you a Nigerian? I will not take what is thine. So property is not this, is not a banking system. You bring this, I give you 2% increase. No. You may have negative increase, depending on where you're coming from. Now, can I tell you this, and I want to say it openly. Can you be a drop pusher and you think your tithe is going anywhere? No. You are reporting yourself to God. I'm busy destroying life. This is what I make out of it. So you can also take. And let's destroy life together. No. No. So don't carry your funny and think that I'm given to the church. Who will give? Is the church in need? All the just bring. No. You better do what makes living profitable. Can I hear your amen? Amen. Somebody's changing level. Amen. In Psalm 92 and verse 12, the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. He shall still bring forth fruit in old age to show that the Lord is upright. It's my rock. There's no righteousness in him. In Psalm 33 and verse 18 and 19, Behold, the eyes of the Lord is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy, to deliver their soul from death and to keep them alive in famine. It will always work when we choose to walk with Jesus. No one here will be a victim of these hard times around the world. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Number two, godliness secures access to our inheritance. Acts 20, verse 32. Now I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give you your own inheritance among them which are sanctified. Our inheritance demands sanctification for access and delivery. Our inheritance demands sanctification both for access and delivery. In Colossians 1, 10 to 12. Colossians. That ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing the knowledge of God. Strengthened with all might according to his glorious power, unto all patience and longsuffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father which has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, walking unto all pleasings unto God, may become partakers of his inheritance. That's how it works. Psalm 37, verse 18 and 19. The Lord knoweth the days of the upright, and their inheritance shall be what? Forever. Say it loud. Now, 19, they shall not be ashamed in the evil time, and in the days of famine they shall be satisfied. So our inheritance covers the days of famine. There's a global famine on the earth today. It's hitting more in some places than others. But there's famine. The whole earth is beginning to burn like an oven. The temperature may differ from one place to another, but at the end, it will burn like an oven. And all the proud, all that will forget about God. They shall be stubble. The days that come, we burn them, leaving them neither root nor branch. But unto you that fear my name in the heat of the heat, you shall be growing up and going forth. And that's you. So, there is no limit to the benefits of a life that is committed to pleasing God. It works both in good time and bad time. It covers all seasons of life. Don't let no devil deceive you. He's very old in the game. He's a master schemer. He's a most subtle being. He deceives people out of their garden and launch them into the wilderness. Don't let him. Don't let pride send you to the forest like Nebuchadnezzar. Don't let pride eat you up like Herod on his throne. Resist, he said, you have not resisted unto death, striving against sin. Resist it. And watch how God will keep decorating your life. Can I hear your amen? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. As it's often said, what we know does not change us. It's what we do with what we know that do. Whatever I tell you to do, do it. It's time to resist sin with a determination to conquer. And I see us conquer. In the name of Jesus. By the blood of Jesus, we have conquered. In the name of Jesus, we have conquered. Lift up your right hand to heaven and give God thanks for light. Give God thanks for light. And give God thanks for light. Give God thanks for light. And now receive grace to walk in the light of the word you have heard since this month began. Receive grace. Receive grace. Not just to document them, not to recite them, not to teach others, but to walk in them. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. You are here tonight in this service and you are not born again yet. That's where the journey to victory over sin and security of eternity begins. That's why it becomes well with us here when it's choking for others. Say to the righteous, it shall be well with them. But the journey begins with Jesus coming to your boat so you can be sure of triumph over the storms of life. And more importantly, you secure eternity with Christ in heaven. So if you're here tonight, you want to say, Jesus, save my soul, forgive my sins, I'm ready. Wherever you may be, both here and any of our viewing centers or around the world where you have your devices, you're connected to this service, please stand to your feet if you can. And I'll pray with you. Jesus, save my soul tonight. Stand to your feet. Jesus, forgive my sins tonight. Please stand to your feet. God bless you and God bless you. There are also people here tonight that need to rededicate their life to Jesus. Jesus, I can sense the brook is dried. I want to return back. I want to reconnect to the flow of the river of life. I want to dedicate my life to Jesus. Wherever you are, stand to your feet also. I want to dedicate my life to Jesus and get back to the main flow. Stand to your feet. And God bless us with you. Jesus loves you. No games. I know my sheep and they know my voice. All of us who may be standing for any of these calls, please move, make your way to the front and we pray. Keep coming. Keep coming. You are out tonight to receive salvation, keep coming. You want to dedicate your life to Jesus tonight, stand to your feet and keep coming. Jesus loves you more than you ever can imagine. May this night your own night. May this night your own night. Somebody is standing up somewhere, wherever you are, get up on your feet and come. Get up now and come. Get up now and come. It's your turn for a change of story. Someone else, stand to your feet and come. Jesus loves you. Get on your feet and come. You can make your day today your day of new beginning. Somebody is joining us from somewhere. Come quickly. This applies to all of our centers. Please approach the altar area now. The pastors are waiting in Jesus' name. Now, for all of us in front, please bow your heads for prayers and lift up your right hand to heaven and pray this simple prayer of faith after me. Say after me right there where you are, Lord Jesus, save my soul. Forgive me all my sins. Wash me with your blood. I believe you died for me. On the third day, you rose again that I may be set free from the power of sin. Today, I accept you as my Lord and my Savior. And I believe am now saved. My sins are forgiven. I'm restored back to the faith. I'm now a child of God. Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul. By your grace, I shall serve you all the days of my life. By your grace, I shall make it to heaven at the end of my journey. By your grace, I shall live overcomer's life on this earth. On this earth. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Amen. Now, be blessed in the name of Jesus. I cover each of you that pray this prayer around the world today with the blood of Jesus. That blood sets you free. It brings you out of that pit where there is no water. You are free at last. You are free forever. Receive grace now to run the race. Receive grace to make it to the end. In Jesus' name. The grace that brought you tonight will keep you for life. In Jesus' name. Congratulations. Congratulations. Please stand and make your way through here to supply your details to the church officials. Shall we all rise, please? Amen. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. Amen. I just sense that somebody's destiny has been untied. The things holding someone bound here has been broken. Somebody's taste here has just changed. Somebody's hunger and thirst after God has just been restored. As we partake of this communion, we are connecting to the blood of Jesus, the sinless blood of Jesus. May every trace of sin at work in any of us be crushed finally tonight. Amen. May we receive from this table the grace to live like Jesus. Amen. Spirit, soul, and body. Amen. Now watch. There is only one spiritual weapon that has access to conscience. It's the blood. What is it? That's why we call it our stronghold. It's the only one that can deal with the feebleness of the spirit, the blood. 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1. Having therefore these promises, let us cleanse ourselves from the feebleness of the spirit and of the flesh, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord. Of all forces, the only one that has access to the conscience of man is the blood. Therefore, lift up your two hands and call for the help of the blood to liberate anyone's conscience here from evil works to serve the living God. From evil works to serve the living God. His word can renew our mind, but only the blood can sanctify our spirit. And the Lord sanctify you wholly, he said. Spirit, soul, and body. We have the blood as that weapon that sanctifies the spirit of man. I partake of the blood in this communion tonight for the sanctification of my spirit, for the cleansing of my conscience. Let the stewards please come, take their position. Stewards, please come, take your positions. Stewards, please come and take your positions. Call the blood of Jesus, sanctify my spirit, sanctify my conscience. Blood of Jesus, sanctify my spirit, sanctify my conscience. Tonight, I receive the blood for the sanctification of my spirit, the cleansing of my conscience, so I can serve the living God. I partake of your sinless blood to be liberated from the hold of sin, to be from the spirit of bondage. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Now, Lord Jesus, we receive this table tonight across board as your flesh and your blood. And we believe in the verdict of Hebrews 9:14 that your blood has power to cleanse our conscience from evil works to serve the living God. Let this be the experience of everyone tonight. Amen. Let every anger clear off. Amen. Let every evil thought be subdued. Amen. Let everyone's spirit be liberated. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Lord, grant us a brand new beginning. Amen. In our walk with you. Thank you. May all the benefits of godliness start finding expression in our lives. Amen. Thank you. You crown the year with your goodness. Let it be our experience. Amen. Take all the praise. The hold of sin is cursed. Amen. The blood has atoned for our freedom. Amen. Now we are set free. Amen. We have changed levels. We are moving closer to Jesus. Amen. We are getting farther with God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We are getting closer to Jesus. Amen. We are walking with more proximity with God. Amen. Things are turning in our favor. Amen. Thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. This is the flesh and the blood of Jesus. We partake of it to live like him. In Jesus' name. Please get seated and take your turn as we'll be directed.
From glory to glory, he's changing me. He's changing me. He's changing me. His likeness and he makes you perfect. The love of God shown to the world. From glory
to glory, he's changing me.
Changing me.
From his likeness and he makes you perfect.
The love of God
shown to the world.
From glory to glory,
he's changing me.
Give the Lord a big hand of praise, everyone. And lift up your two hands. Together, let's give God thanks for the word encounter tonight. God can only change us by his word. He has no other means of doing that. Give him thanks for the life-changing word that we have heard tonight from the throne of grace. Celebrate and magnify him. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. The first of the three rallies is this coming Saturday. This is what happens. Let's therefore go outside the gate bearing his reproach so he can roll away our reproach. Get excited in public identification with Jesus. It erodes and removes your public shame as you do. We also have the electronic form of the advert sent to all your friends and those who even speak against you and your God, sent to them. Amen. If they are wise, they won't do that. Send to them. There's a winning wisdom baptism coming that will always change people's story. Send to everyone you can find. And then when it's time in your various areas in your district, be excited to be part of it. If you're ashamed of me, he said, and of my word, I'll be ashamed of you before my Father and his angels. And that would miss a lot. So let's go forth. And as we go outside the gate behind his reproach, he rolls away our reproaches. We have had so many testimonies like that. How many? Amen. If your God has been is that good, why is he not giving you children? And God said, I hear. And did it the same month. Can I hear your amen? Because she still went back. No, I'm not ashamed because of Jesus. And God said, so you did? Okay. The battle is over. That's what going outside the gate does. It throws away a public shame. No one will have any trace of shame around his or her life and family forever. Yeah. Lift up your two hands. And thank God for the Priscilla Encounters package for you. And thank God for the covenant responsibility that will help you maximize it. And thank God for grace to take it. Lift up your two hands. And give God thanks for what he's opened you to and opened me to tonight. Lift up your two hands. Give him thanks because he will do what he has said and he'll confirm it in your life.
Thank you so much for listening to the end. I pray that whatever that you have listened today, you are not going just to keep it, but you're going to do what God has told you through this message. And please kindly, if you're new here or you are not, you have not subscribed, kindly just click on the red button below the video and subscribe to this my channel. And also you can share this video with someone else. Thank you so much and see you in my next video. Bye.